There we go. There we go. I can't hold anything else. I can't use that here. I can't use that here. I can't use that here. There we go. All right.
Be more comforting.
Just let me in, Rebecca. It will all be over.
good bed. It's Mommy. It's your grandma. I need you to let me in, sweetie.
I just wanted to visit you. Don't you miss me? I bought you something. I thought maybe you could slit your wrist for me. Just a little cut.
Oh, what's wrong, Rebecca?
Don't be afraid of your grandma!
There we go.
Thank you.
Hold anything else.
Right. Are you sure this is the right one?
Come a long way. It's nice not to be the one down there for a change.
Mr. Dover?
I think you can just call me Raymond at this point.
Do you always just pass out and wake up on the floor?
It takes a lot out of you. I've never simply walked out of here after. You get used to it.
I'll be sure to clean the floors better. Raymond, will this ever end?
I honestly don't know. I've been doing this a long time, Rebecca. I've traveled all over, learning everything I can. I've never found anything that could put a stop to it. So no, I don't think it does.
So, we're just like this forever?
It was hard for me too. But this is the life we get. We have to face our worst selves, constantly. But the better we know ourselves, the stronger we are. Why don't you head home? Get some rest. Who knows what's coming tonight?
Oh. I'm here.
Hey! I made it!
Is everything all right?
Yeah. You can come up.
You do know you have the walkie-talkie, right?
You can come up.
Just go ahead. Mm-hmm. I need to find something in my backpack.
What exactly? The gear should already be at the camp.
You will know when the time comes. Patience.
Very well. You can catch up, yes? The path leads through that canyon.
Mm-hmm. I know.
Oh, have you tied down the bow?
Jake, I know this might sound stupid under the circumstances, but I am glad we came back here.
Yeah, I feel ya. Yeah, the place is beautiful. Still,
we can't forget what we came here for in the first place, I know. But as soon as... we're settled in, I am off to the Jawahaka village. And what if they will not speak to us?
Come on, let's not get ahead of ourselves. You're a phenomenal interpreter. If anyone can communicate with them, it's you.
Good thing I have an anthropologist at hand, Dr. Higgins.
Okay, I found the tent.
Is everything all right?
Spacious interior, luxurious cots, not all that fancy. Oh, and there's a dirt floor.
As long as it doesn't leak, I am fine with it.
Soul Trail always delivers. At first glance, it looks like we have everything we might need.
Perfecto.
Well, that's everything. We're officially settled in.
You know what that means, don't you?
I remember the agreement, but maybe we should reconsider this. I'm not sure it's the best idea for you to visit them alone.
Cariño, you know I have to do this. It's the only way to make them talk.
Oh, don't worry.
It'll be all right. Better pick up some wood. Let's have a romantic dinner.
Romantic canned beans.
Use your imagination.
Johnny, I can't seem to find a bag or two. Are you sure you brought everything?
Yeah, everything the porters left. Why? Is anything missing?
I'm not sure yet, but it feels that way.
Looks like everything's ready. Mia, can you bring me a lighter?
Remember when I mentioned we seemed to be lacking some equipment?
Don't tell me.
Yeah, we have no fire.
Not a single lighter, nor a box of matches. We ordered both. Did you check everywhere?
Did. You need to do it the old-fashioned way.
Well, not the best start of the act.
Hun, get the campfire started, please. Hun, get the campfire started, please.
I need to find something dry. Ha!
Hun, get the campfire started, please.
Oh, Mia! The fire is burning.
Coming. Give me a minute.
How do you do it?
What?
You seem so calm.
I am calm. I don't know how to explain it, but strangely, it feels safer here than there.
Oh, I don't know. Jaguars, venomous spiders, and snakes. Let's not forget the scorpions. A mere ant's bite hurts like hell.
I am well aware of that. But still, we have a chance to achieve something, make a difference. At home, all we could have done was be helpless and wait. I prefer the wilderness.
I'll miss you, and I'll be worried. But I'll do some work in the meantime. When we meet, I should be able to catch a fish and start a fire with a single spear strike.
You say you'll be afraid, and yet you are in high spirits. That's what I like about you.
Nonetheless, I'm a bit worried about you meeting the Yabawaka.
Everything will be fine. I need to go alone. We already agreed that's the only way. Besides, they don't seem to like you.
They don't seem to like outsiders. They shot arrows at a military chopper.
Hard to blame them. Since you published your book, they've been under siege by the media, scientists, doctors. The World Health Alliance established a medical camp and probably performed research, violating the tribe's taboos. But I will convince them. I have to.
Hello? Mia?
Hey, sleepyhead. Finally up?
You left already? Why didn't you wake me up?
You know I hate farewells.
Well, I was hoping we'd have breakfast together. You surprised me, that's all.
Admit it. You thought I forgot your birthday, didn't you? Well, I didn't.
Exactly what I wanted. It even has solar batteries.
And a macro element scanner. Check yourself to see if you're not missing any. We've been here only a few days, but stress can wear you out.
Tell me about it. Rested and well fed.
Perfect. And keep it that way. We need that brain of yours working at peak performance.
I'll try to take good care of it. Have you found them yet?
See. And as expected, they don't want to talk. They behave as if I am not here.
But they haven't driven you away. That's a good sign. You need to convince them that you're one of them.
Agreed. That seems to be the right course of action. I will sleep on the edge of the village and only eat what I can find.
Just be careful, please.
I will. But if I am to live like them, we can't be talking so often.
You're right. They're suspicious of technology.
If anything goes wrong, I'll leave the village and get you on the radio. Otherwise, you can assume everything is just fine and there is no need to worry.
All right. Let's focus on the goal. I'll be focusing on indexing new plant species. I think I saw a few new specimens around here. Me. Mia, I know I was supposed to not call, but a line snapped and I fell down a good 30 feet.
Just Mia, are you okay?
I'm not sure.
Hold on. I'll walk away a bit so they can't hear you. Let me know once you have checked yourself.
That's definitely not good. It's all right. Nothing's broken. Just scratches and bruises. Nothing to worry about.
In the jungle, every scratch can be dangerous. You need to patch everything up. You remember how to do it?
Yes, I do. Molinaria. Long, smooth, acute leaf, surrounded by yellow flowers.
That's it.
Okay, I'll go look for it.
You should have it in your notepad. Call me when you've treated your wound.
Roger that. Over and out. Here I am, all wrapped up nicely.
Does it hurt?
Not much.
Good. Hopefully it will heal fast.
So, how are you doing?
I'll be initiated in a few days. I am optimistic. I expect to be treated as one of their own after that, and I should be able to ask some questions then. Some elders are opposed to this, though. Luckily, Chief Kuini is on my side.
Why are they opposed?
I think they were divided even before I joined them. The chief wanted to approach the World Health Alliance peacefully, but a few of the elders insisted on fighting. Now, the Jabahuaca basically have two factions.
Sounds dangerous, Mia. Be careful.
I'm not in any danger. Told you, I'm optimistic. Jake, please come in. Jake, I need you here. Jake, please. Please answer me.
Mia? What happened? Mia, speak to me. Mia! What's going on over there?
Thank you.
Hello? Jake, what the hell is going on there? Come on, speak to me, Jake! ¿Por qué no me respondes?
Mia! Mia? God damn it, this radio. Hello? Can anyone hear me? I had an accident. I don't know what happened. Please, help. Over. Fuck.
Mm-hmm.